Saying good afternoon and welcoming everybody. I'm joined with my sister here, Eva Jenkins.
And my sister here, Laquita Cooks.
What we really want to talk about today is about mistakes. A lot of times we might feel like we can't make them.
Right.
We might be really hard on ourselves, or maybe even in our upbringing we were told not to make mistakes or to do everything right.
Right.
And we can be really just hard on ourselves because of our past.
And often with our past, we forget that it is that, our past. And that is the number one mistake, which is what we're talking about, is making mistakes. And we make that mistake in thinking and not allowing our past to be just that, our past. And so today, we're going to bring what's really on the heart, so that we can get beyond our past and know that in making mistakes, we serve a God who has an unmeasurable amount of grace.
Yes, and just learning how to take that own grace to ourselves of what He's given us can be actually walking by faith. So it's really just taking everything that you've learned of who He is and applying it to your own life. Well, after share with you a mistake that I feel like wasn't so small, but kind of big, but I overcame it. So about 3 weeks ago, I had heard something and I kind of just ran with it without digging more information, without finding out more. I just listened and I was like, I'm gonna run with this. And in the midst of not slowing down and paying attention and seeing if this is really something I should be doing, I had made a big mistake. So I had to go back to two people and apologize for my mistake.
Oh wow.
And it could have been really simple for me to just say, oh, they may not even notice that I made a mistake. Or we can brush it off and, oh, well, it wasn't that bad. And we can make excuses our mistake.
We can.
And so I really had to say, what is the heart of God in this situation? Because I can easily do things in my own strength, with I already did, and it ended up being disastrous and not something I should have been doing. And so with the opportunity of just saying, hey, I made a mistake, I was wrong in this, I was able to receive actually grace and mercy from them. They were so gracious towards me, and I was like, do you know what, God, that is your love for us.
And it's unmeasurable.
It really is.
It is absolutely unmeasurable. And when you talk about mistakes, I was thinking, my husband and I was looking at a Christian movie. A lady that was in the movie had played in another movie. And my husband said, oh, that's the same lady that played in War Room. And I said, no, it's not. I said, all people start to look alike to you. You know, I said, and that's not the same lady. He said, yes, it is. And I said, okay, but it's not. And so I didn't just let that go. And I did say to my husband, you need to trust me. That's not the same lady. So I Googled it as we were watching the movie. I Googled it and I found out, be ready for this, I found out that that was indeed the same lady.
Oh.
So the entire evening went by and I said, my husband said to me, he said, well, maybe it's not. And I just kind of sat and let him went with thinking that you know, maybe it wasn't. And so I couldn't continue forward even in the day. God says, you need to let him know that you were wrong and that he was right. And so I said, oh, babe, yeah, by the way, that is the same lady that played in War Room.
Yeah.
And he looked at me and he said, oh, it is? And it was no big deal. And so my mistake was not acknowledging that I had made a mistake. No big deal in the end when he said, oh, it was? He said, yeah, I thought it was. I said, yeah, you were absolutely right. And in acknowledging that, I found that as we continued to talk, God was like, was that so hard? Was that so hard?
Mm-hmm.
And here it is. my sister and I are sitting here wanting to make known to you all and the world, it's okay to make a mistake.
Yeah.
The thing is to be big enough to acknowledge the mistake that you made and that God's grace is unmeasurable.
So with making mistakes, obviously we want to be able to correct ourselves right away and admit our wrongs.
So in 2 Corinthians
12:9,
it reads, "And he said unto me, My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness." His strength is made perfect in our weakness.
Yes.
And the very last portion of that is, "Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me."
Wow, that is powerful. So you know that when you have made a mistake and just going to someone and apologizing and saying that I was wrong,
yes,
can actually be a weakness of us, because let's admit it, we are selfish beings, we are prideful, we don't want to admit our wrongs, we want to appear to be perfect and have it all together.
Oh yes.
But that essentially is our weakness, that when we confess, we get to see God's power covering us and see His strength in the things that we are weak in.
And I love that portion of the scripture where He says, "For my strength is made perfect in weakness." So in the areas in which we are weak, we have the assurance in knowing that if we trust in God, that His strength is made perfect in our weakness.
Yeah.
And it also backs up what He said at the beginning, that my grace, His grace is sufficient.
Even about our infirmities,
yes,
right? Because we carry these on not just from our natural sins, but from generation to generation.
Oh, wow, yeah.
And so then it's just saying, okay, it's God's power that covers me, that He says I am sanctified in Him. So it's just allowing Him to do that when we can confess our need for Him.
And something that Eva said earlier when she talked about pride, and when we make a mistake, getting back to the very cause of what we're dealing with the issue at hand, dealing with the mistake, because what will happen is that that mistake, if not corrected, will lead to another mistake. And if we don't correct it, now we are in danger of crossing the line and going into a prideful mindset or having a prideful attitude.
Yeah.
And we know that pride is very dangerous, right? And so we want to deal with those mistakes. We want to make things right as God presents them to us. Make it right so that the snowball or the domino effect of pride does not come in and take us out.
Yes, such a great point.
Yeah.
Because pride, there's so many sins connected to that.
Oh, well,
it's not just that. So you just want to be able to constantly examine yourself and confess your sins to someone you trust and have them pray for you.
Yes.
That's why we do life together.
We do it together. And when I tell you we do it together, we do it together.
We really do.
Eva calls and keeps me accountable, and the same thing, me for her. And we've done a prayer accountability, which was amazing. It was tough.
Yeah.
There was times when Eva would call, or I was calling, one would forget, or we would end up sleeping in, but we
Because it was at 5 o'clock in the morning.
5 a.m. in the morning. And this will truly test your accountability, not so much as to each other, but to God.
Exactly.
Yeah. But we made it through.
Oh, yeah.
We made it through the time in which we had set to do it. We made it through. And now we're on to the next challenge.
We are.
Yay.
Doing live videos to encourage you
yes.
who might be going through exactly what we just described. So we hope this encourages you out there to just say, I was wrong. Or just being able to take ownership and examine yourself daily to see how
yes.
are you walking with God. You know, we constantly want to be making sure that we are making those changes to say, is this something that glorifies God in the way that we deal with others in our relationships, especially our spouses.
Especially our spouses. Hear that, spouses? God bless you.
God bless.